Most of us use crystals every day in the form of regular sugar and salt. When we look at these crystals under a microscope, not much is going on. But if we force the crystals to grow in a thin layer on a microscope slide and illuminate them with polarized light, it's an entirely different story. This little trick also allows us to observe crystal growth under the microscope. For this video to make sense, I will shortly describe the basic science going on here, but this is in no way the full story, but just a brief overview to let you know a bit about what is going on. So a crystal is a solid where the individual molecules are arranged in a highly ordered three-dimensional structure, like we see in grains of sugar and table salt. Compared to when a substance is dissolved in a liquid and all the individual molecules are just floating randomly around. When we then take the solution, put a thin layer on a slide and let it crystallize, the molecules rearrange themselves to form a solid. The spacey colors we see with the polarized light appears because some crystals are what is called birefringent. This means that light will behave differently depending on the way it enters the crystals. So when we shine a white polarized light through the birefringent crystals, the individual light waves will interact differently with the crystals, altering the waves a bit in respect to each other. And depending on the thickness and orientation of the crystals, we get a change in color. Depending on which substance we crystallize, the looks and crystallizing speed changes dramatically. Here you can see how vitamin C, also known as ascorbic acid, looks when it crystallizes. Here it sped up about 6 times. This compound often makes these round structures, and when the crystallization process is over, we're able to get some nice, colorful and artistic images. This substance is lidocaine, which is commonly used as a local anesthetic. So if you're one of the lucky ones who have been given a shot of local anesthetic at the dentist, this is most likely what they injected you with. This substance crystallizes faster than vitamin C, and no time lapse is needed to observe the growth. The lidocaine is one of my favorite chemicals to crystallize, as it makes incredibly beautiful structures. In this image, I mixed it with a bit of gentisic acid, which is a breakdown product of the medication aspirin. The fastest crystallizing substance I've ever encountered is sodium acetate trihydrate, also known as hot ice, which is the stuff in the heating pads we use as hand warmers in the winter. When this compound is in its liquid form, the liquid is what is known as a supersaturated solution, which means that it really wants to crystallize, but it needs something to initiate the process, a nucleation site. So when the liquid just barely touches another crystal, it sets off an unstoppable chain reaction that makes the entire solution crystallize in seconds. This process puts out a lot of heat, and the crystals can reach temperatures of up to 55 C. That's more than 130 Fahrenheit for all of you Americans. Here are some more of the different compounds I've crystallized so far. A huge thanks to my Patreons at patreon.com for their support. If you want to help me make more and better videos in the future, as well as get your name listed here, you can also support me on patreon.com, and I will put a link to that down in the description, along with links to the materials I used to make the polarized light and other materials I used making this video. If you want to buy some of the images as prints, I will also leave a link for that in the description. If you have any questions or ideas to what you want to see under the microscope in the future, please leave a comment below. Thank you for watching.